Hi there, I hope you are doing well. It's Bibi Cameron here and welcome to a new video. So today I want to share with you the latest car I post in my blog. And it's this car here made using this gorgeous background stamp by Simon Says Stamp called Cosmos. And I'm so in love with this stamp that I really wanted to see how it looks when you stamp that beautiful image on different cardstock colors and different cardstock qualities. So I also did some heat embossing and I used different ink colors. Also add color to all those panels and I make a few cards I will be sharing here in my YouTube channel, on Instagram, and of course on my blog. So I'm going to start today by setting the stamp on my Tim Holtz platform. And I'm going to set this precision stamping tool on rubber because this is a clean rubber stamp and it's really easy to attach this stamp to the platform. I'm going to use a 6x6 inches piece of watercolor paper. This is 300 grams. And I'm going to be using also antique lining distress ink to stamp this image. And as it's very possible that you don't get this completely stamped in the first try, you might need to stamp twice. And if you do, like in this case here, I will recommend to ink the stamp only on those areas in which you cannot get the image crisp on the paper. This is to avoid getting a super dark image. We need an image we can see, but we are going to need to cover those hard lines at the edges of the image somehow later on. Okay, so I'm going to use this ultra fine tip Nubo Aqua brush. This is brand new, it comes like that. You need to assemble the brush, so you need to screw this like so, and it will make click. Then all you need to do is to unscrew this part here like so and put the water inside the barrel. Then you will need to screw all the parts together and you will be ready to go. I'm going to be using the new Nubo watercolor pencils by Tonic Studios. They are highly pigmented watercolor pencils and they come in two tins with 12 colors each one. This is Brilliantly Vibrant and this one here is Hair and Skin Tones. I'm going to be mixing colors from both boxes. And something important is to tell you that this is not by any means a tutorial. I'm a hobbyist, I'm not a professional watercolorist. It's kind of the way I found to add color to stamped images and make cards. So what I do here is just go with the pencil over the stamped lines. I follow the lines of the stamped image. And once I lay down the pencil, I use the water brush slightly wet to spread the diluted pigment towards the edges of the petals. I apply a light wash of color first, and when it's dry, I use a darker pencil. I lay down some lines like so, and then I comb with the water brush and blend all together. I apply darker colors at the center of the flower and a little bit at the edges of the petals, just to give it a little bit of shape and also to cover the antique lining distress ink. This ink doesn't blend as easy. The distress ink doesn't blend as easy. It's not going to disappear. It's always going to be there to guide us and to tell us where we have to lay down the color. Of course, we only count with the outlines and some lines that give texture and shape to the flowers, so we can fill these flowers with color in many different ways. So all I do is applying color with the pencil directly on the dry paper and then blend with the water brush. I apply so many layers of colors as I want, or just apply a couple of washes and that's it. And I was kind of messing up my flower there because I apply a brown watercolor pencil on wet paper, so I got a kind of discoloration in that corner, but the watercolor is very forgiving. Normally when I'm working with watercolors, I just work in a flower and then I go to another flower waiting for the color or the washes of color to dry. But for this video, I'm working just in one flower. So you will see that suddenly some of other flowers in that panel are going to be filled with color, and that's off camera because I'm doing exactly the same. There is no need to show you that over and over. So I add different colors, and then in those areas I feel I want to lay down a shadow, I just do it. I add contrasting colors, so a yellow and an orange, a fuchsia and a red, a purple and a dark blue. And I know this is not a watercolor looking composition because you expect the watercolor to be more loose and soft. And it kind of looks like if I color this using coloring pencils or waxed pencils. And I actually consider both media very, very similar. Same principles in terms of color application. Difference are the kind of solution you use to blend the colors and also the opacity. The waxed colors are really opaque and the watercolors are translucent. But honestly, for me, it doesn't make any difference in terms of color application. I follow the same principles. It means I do exactly the same. Even when I'm using crayons or watercolor paints, kind of the same thing. I apply a little bit of the pigment and then I spread it with a blending solution. Okay, I'm going to slow down here. You see this flower here? I'm only going to apply 2 or 3 washes of color. So you don't have to apply a bunch of washes of color as I did. That's an option. Here, what I do is laying down a very light wash of color and then I come with the pencil and I apply a little bit of pencil over the edges like so, but in those areas of the image that are supposed to be foldings, I do not apply ink. I'm applying here a little bit of yellow color. So when I finish coloring this flower, those parts are going to look like if they were curling up from those petals. For the center of the flowers, I just grab the yellow watercolor pencil and I draw a kind of circle just in the middle of that part there. I like to leave a little bit of white area around and highlight the edges with a brown watercolor pencil or with a darker color. So this is another way to do this kind of coloring a little bit quicker. So another thing I do, you see there, I always go over the edges of the image with the pencils all around the image. So because I stamped this image using antique lining distress ink, you can see the hard lines of the stamped image anyway. So it's very unlikely that you can get rid completely of these lines. So what I do to try to camouflage those lines is adding the pencil directly on that stamped line, and then with the water brush, I wash the ink and I try to blend everything together. I also like to add blue here and there, purple, and I think that makes this composition a little bit more fun. But of course, that's a style. You can also print your own personal style on your cards. So this is watercolor pencils for card making. And to finish, I like to add all over my stamped images after watercoloring some dots with a white or a black fine tip pen or marker. It is super mega duper important to wait for the watercolor washes to dry before applying these dots. I completely spoiled that flower there because I didn't allow the washes of colors to dry before applying others and even these black dots just in the center of that flower. But it really doesn't matter. That was a testing cheat and also to explain you how I did this and also do it very, very quick. So I have to be honest with you, and coloring the whole panel is not something you are going to do in a couple of minutes. It's going to take at least 1 hour or two. So this is the kind of project for people who enjoy coloring. Honestly, I lose the track of the time when I'm doing this. So this is something I really enjoy. I play some music and I just start coloring. But if you are the kind of person who likes quick and easy projects, don't get discouraged. This stamp is very versatile, so you can also make quick and easy projects. So before I forget, the sentiment for you was made using this die by Simon Says stamp that actually says "here for you." But I only use those two words to be able to make a card for any occasion. So that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel or visit my blog for more ideas and inspiration. Check out the links in the video description with information about where to buy the products I have used in this video. Thank you very much for watching and happy crafting. Bye.